So when NASA announced the discovery of the TRAPPIST-1 system, they got everybody excited, the scientific community, the public. You know, you had 7 Earth-sized planets, several of which might have the right temperature to host liquid water, you know, prime targets for the search for life outside the solar system. So what really captured our attention was when they tried to simulate the system, they found that it just fell apart. Planets started colliding with each other on really short times. You know, and what are the chances that we would catch the system at this very special time right before destruction? It seems more likely that there's something more going on, something that's keeping the system stable. So the additional key piece of information here is actually when you look at how long each planet takes to go around the central star. Those orbital periods, they form an incredibly precise progression. For every 2 orbits of the outermost planet, the next one in does 3, the next one in after that does 4, then 6, 9, 15, 24. It's just like clockwork. We don't see that long a so-called resonant chain in any other planetary system that we know. When we tune that precisely, we can get these systems to survive for as long as we can possibly simulate them on a supercomputing cluster. So it really seems that it's this really remarkable orbital configuration that allows the system to survive long enough for us to see it today. But how am I going to communicate this with people? And then one day, Matt Russo, he knocked on my door and he said,
"Can you help me out? Do you have any simulations of the TRAPPIST-1 system I could use?"
And I said, "Well, I have thousands. How many do you want?"
So the thing that stuck out to me most about the TRAPPIST-1 system was this amazing pattern of resonances, how each planet's orbit is a simple ratio of its neighbors. And I realized that that's the exact same thing that makes music sound good and that makes it rhythmic. So we simulated the system. We scaled their orbital frequencies into the human hearing range. And made it play a note for every time a planet transits in front of the star. So this may sound like a remarkable coincidence, but it turns out that the system was tuned this way early on when it was evolving. Then, we added a drumbeat for every time a planet passes its neighbor. Finally, we converted the star's brightness data into sound and included it for a little more flair. It's kind of funny because most planetary systems are like bands of amateur musicians. They're all playing parts, but at different speeds. TRAPPIST-1 is different, though. It's like a supergroup where all 7 members are synchronizing their parts in nearly perfect time.
It seems somehow poetic that this really precise clockwork configuration that allows us to generate this beautiful music can at the same time be responsible for the system surviving to the present day. My name is Dan Tamayo. I work at the Center for Planetary Sciences at the University of Toronto.
And I'm Matt Russo from the Canadian Institute for Theoretical Astrophysics. And you can hear what other systems sound like and learn more at system-sounds.com.